Well, hello, this is it. Are you all this evening? How many of you are ready to praise God tonight? No, just two of you. How many of you are ready to praise God tonight? No, I can't hear you. How many of you are ready to praise God tonight? Let me hear you shout the name of Jesus. Shout the name of Jesus. Let's go.
Shout it out, God is good. DC. Declare tonight, say, Lord, you are good. Come on, DCC, declare, Lord, you are good. And your mercy endure forever. Let's see hands in the air tonight. Come on. Come on, DCC. Sing with us. Here we go. Let's sing it this way. This is the word here in the flesh, living among the meek and lowly. The voice of God, is every breath, salvation of the world. One more time. Be holy. Be holy. Be holy. Hosanna, holy. Sing the name. We're going to sing that third verse just one more time. Come on. This is his home. Let's sing.
This is his home. Here in our chest. At every door, the Savior.
I love you, my Lord.
Jesus, set me free. Look at the wounds that give me life, grace flowing from me side, no greater sacrifice. What is done, what is done, all the glory and the honor to the Son. My sins are forgiven, my future is heaven. I praise God for what He's done.
We praise You, Lord. Sing, come on, let's sing.
Sing for the freedom He has won. Even death is dead and done. He's alive, has overcome.
Speak, say that name.
My sins are forgiven.
again this morning. And to see you all. I got to hear you saying this evening. What you waited? I don't know what you prayed for this fasting. Can you see God moving that mountain that is in front of you? See what? Can you see God fixing your marriage tonight? In your business, see what the Lord has done. What you waited for has come to pass. See what the Lord has done. Oh, see what. Can you see what the Lord has done? Can you see what the Lord is? What you waiting for? What you waiting for?
It's come to pass.
See what the Lord. Oh, see what the Lord.
See what the Lord.
Can you see what the Lord has done? Can you see what the Lord is? What you waiting for? What you waiting for?
It's come to pass.
See what the Lord.
See what the Lord has.
Can you see what the Lord.
See what the Lord has.
See what the Lord has done. Can you see what the Lord is? What you prayed for? What you what you prayed for, what you waited
for.
Can you see that thing coming to pass tonight? Can you see that thing coming to pass tonight? Can you see what? Lift up your voices tonight to the Lord.
Can we sing this tonight?
Tonight.
Sing, I receive what the Lord has done. I receive tonight.
I receive what the Lord has done. What you waiting for? What you waiting for? Has come
tonight.
We receive what the Lord has done.
Just one more time. See what the Lord. Can you see with the eyes of your faith? Hallelujah.
Can you see what the Lord is? What we waited for has come to pass.
What we waited for.
What we waited for has come to pass.
What we waited for.
What we waited for has come.
Awesome God, miracles you are.
An awesome God of miracles you are. An awesome God of miracles you are. What's his name?
Jesus, wonder-working God.
I want the voices with a bit of strings. An awesome God. Come on, I want you to declare that tonight. An awesome God. awesome God of miracles you are.
Jesus,
he's my wonder-working God. And Jesus,
wonder-working God.
Jesus,
my
Jesus, he's my wonder-working God. Come on, one more time. And Jesus,
he's my wonder-working God.
An incredible
God of power. You are
love, love,
love. An incredible God of love. You are
an incredible God of love.
God of love.
I sense his love in this house, in this very atmosphere.
Jesus, wonder-working God.
Just one more time, we want to say it to him. An incredible God of love. You are. That's who you are. An incredible God of love. You are. An incredible God of love. You are.
Jesus,
he's my wonder-working God. And it's Jesus, he's my wonder-working God. He's my wonder work. Take it up a key. An incredible God of love.
God of love. You are.
I sense his love in this place. Whatever it is that you have need of tonight. I sense his healing power. I sense his healing virtue. Jesus, you're my wonder-working God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You're the best in the mind of the Lord. Impossible when you put your trust in God. And nothing is impossible.
Your name is worth. Hearken to the voice of God to be.
Is there anything
too hard for me?
Then put your trust in God alone and rest upon his word.
For everything, yes, everything
is possible with God.
Nothing is impossible
when you put your trust in God.
Nothing is impossible when you trust in him. His
work. Hearken to the voice.
Hearken to the voice of God to be.
Is there anything?
Is there anything too hard for me?
Then put your trust in God alone and rest upon his word. For everything,
oh everything, yes everything
is possible.
Impossible when
thinking, why on earth are we singing all those songs? Those are the songs that we grew up in.
Yes.
We grew up in the house with those kind of songs because it was part of our, can I use the word legacy? That's the word we're praying for tonight. And when we pray for legacy, I want you to think about two people, Pastor Fred and Sister Nell. Can we put them up on the screen? We wouldn't be here if it wasn't for these two people. Can we get their picture up on the screen right now? Dr. Fred and Sister Nell Roberts on the screen. All right, praise the Lord. Who in 1979 decided that they would start a house of prayer for all nations. Pastor Fred traveled the United States of America. I'm just telling people this because we have a lot of new folks with us and literally a brand new congregation. But in 1979, as they were traveling the United States and they had it with this country and with the apartheid regime and all of that, and Pastor Fred came upon the concept of a Christian center. And then the word of the Lord came to them that they would place before them was a lesser and a greater vision. And the greater vision was for them to come back and start a house of prayer for all nations, which they did in 1979. And they began way back there in just a living room. It was a living room with a couple of people in there. Incidentally, that living room was composed of some of our elders that founded the church that were part of the board that were impacted by a phenomenal move of God, believe it or not, that was happening in a Catholic monastery in a place called Marion Hill. A phenomenal move of the Spirit. I'm just saying that because God can work. He's not bound. And there was a certain father in that monastery that would do the Catholic Mass. And then after that, he would just begin to flow in the Spirit, begin to pray for people, word of knowledge, begin to prophesy. Incredible things happened. But when we look at Pastor Fred and Sister Nell, we have to ask the question, who were they impacted by? Because that's part of our legacy. We're impacted by them, and we carry their DNA and their spirit. But who were they impacted with? Well, Pastor Fred's folks were, well, let's start with Sister Nell. Her mom and dad were impacted by a phenomenal man of God by the name of Smith Wigglesworth. And here's this man, Smith Wigglesworth, who at one time there was a dead person, and he pushed her up against the wall. I think he punched her in the stomach. And God forbid that we should do that today. Can you imagine what would happen in Instagram and social media? But he had phenomenal miracles. This is the signs, wonders, miracles ministry, the supernatural, the move of the Holy Ghost. Her family was impacted by that. And she was born in Pietermaritzburg and in that area. And her folks, her father, who was an alcoholic and was a good boxer, got wonderfully touched by that movement. Pastor Fred, on his side, his father was a tall gentleman who was, I think, in the police force, and on his deathbed with some illness. But they were impacted by John G. Lake. John G. Lake. Here's a picture of John G. Lake. And you say, well, who's this guy? Who's this dude? Looks like he could be a doctor, or I don't know what, or a father, or a Franciscan monk, or something like that. But this gentleman, let me just tell you a little bit about this man. This man traveled all the way to Azusa Street in the early 1900s. If you've heard me talk about Charles Parham and how that he had a group of students that examined the Bible to see, is there such a thing as the baptism of the Holy Ghost, and what is the evidence? And so 1899, on the 31st, as they came into 1900, they all emphatically, all of them, and this was in Topeka, Kansas, they said, without a doubt, Brother Parham, there is such a thing as the Holy Ghost, and the evidence is speaking in other tongues. And nobody had received the baptism of the Holy Ghost, and it took a woman, Agnes Osman, to say, well, if we have this irrefutable evidence, would you lay your hand? She stepped forward. Cyril, a woman stepped forward amongst a whole lot of men and said, I need you. And they all like, whoa, like, took a lot of boldness. Laid hands on Agnes, and she started to speak in other tongues. And she, for 3 days, she spoke fluent Chinese. It's documented in the journals. But why I'm telling you this is because down in California, Azusa Street, was an African-American gentleman by the name of William Seymour. And he only had one eye, but with one eye, he could see more than most people can see with two eyes. William Seymour, in fact, when he went to Charles Parham to the Bible school, he had to sit outside. He sat outside. But here he is in Azusa Street, and God used William Seymour to bring about the phenomenal movement of the Holy Ghost, the Pentecostal movement. John G. Lake was influenced by that man, William Seymour. So our roots, we're somehow involved with William Seymour. Hallelujah. Thank God for William Seymour, amen, who with one eye can see more than most of us can see with two eyes. I'll just throw that in for nothing. But why I'm telling you this is because John G. Lake came to South Africa, and there were two gentlemen that were impacted by these men, in particular John G. Lake. And one of them was Reverend Nicholas Bengu, who basically was responsible for starting the Assemblies of God, a giant in the faith that started a lot of churches and was responsible for the Pentecost. He was a holy man. He preached the Word of God with signs, wonders, and miracles. And that's part of your and my legacy, inextricably linked to all of this. We are part of this. The other gentleman that basically came and was impacted by John G. Lake because he started the Apostolic Faith Mission was a gentleman by the name of Reverend Richard Ngidi. Richard Ngidi, who started the Apostolic Faith Mission. Both these, and there's others that I could tell you about that were impacted, that impacted this nation. And you and I, that's why I'm highlighting this tonight, family, is because this is part of our legacy. It's part of our legacy. It's part of our legacy. We're in the L, Jubilee, J-U-B-I-L, legacy. This is our legacy. And that's why we have to fight for our country. We have to fight for our city. We have to fight for righteousness. We have to fight for peace. We have to fight that. Do you know that it's actually illegal in Sweden and those countries? It's illegal to be poor. It's a crime to be poor. Poverty has been declared illegal. You cannot be poor in Sweden and those countries. They have, it's basically a crime. If you're poor, you're a criminal. Go figure. But we have a legacy, and it's up to us and the Church of Jesus Christ. And there's never been more of a time than for you and I to take our place and do what we've been called to do. So tonight, I want us to get the first point up, all right? The first point. It's all about a legacy. And the first point there, point number one, is that we ask that our children will grow strong and exert dominion on the earth. As moms and dads, we have a responsibility with our kids. And the Bible says, train up a child in the way that it should go, so that it would not depart from there. And sometimes I know our kids, they take a bit of a turn and whatever, but we have to trust and believe that what we have spoken and declared and prophesied and decreed over their lives, those seeds that we have planted, shall surely come to pass. Now, you might not have children, but let's stand in agreement tonight for our children, because if you die and it stops there, then we actually have no legacy. that nothing is perpetuated. Hello? And that's what the devil wants. Remember in Genesis 3:15, there's enmity between the seed of the serpent and the seed of the woman. So the enemy is after our seed, and he'll do whatever he can to get to our children, to get them off track, to get them distracted, to get their eyes off God, to get them to stop serving God. But we have to stand in agreement together. Hallelujah. We're joining our faith together. If you don't have children, then I'm trusting, join your faith together with those that do. And these are the two scriptures that we're going to use tonight, that for our children, all right? Psalm 112 verse 2 says, his descendants, that's yours and mine, will grow strong on the earth. The family of a decent person will be blessed. We're declaring that our children are going to be strong for the Lord, that they will be blessed of God, highly favored, that what the Lord started in us, he will not only continue in them, but it would multiply to a greater degree. I don't want my children to do exactly what I'm doing. I want them to take it further. They can stand on my shoulder just like I'm standing on Pastor Fred's shoulder. Thank God we didn't. Well, we had to start from the beginning, literally when it burnt down. But, I mean, we could stand on their shoulders. Hallelujah. The foundation was laid already. And so we can go much further. And our children can stand on our shoulders, your shoulders. And they can go much further for God. Hallelujah. Can you say praise the Lord? The next scripture that we're going to look at. Because they are always giving and sharing, truly their children are a joyful blessing. You say, but Pastor, I don't see that in my kids. Well, you just keep confessing these scriptures. Remember, we walk by faith, not by sight. I don't care what they manifest. I don't care what they're saying. I don't care. I see them with their hands uplifted, praising God, serving God, with a Bible in their hand, preaching, laying hands on the sick. With the eyes of my faith, with the eyes of your faith, what are you seeing your children doing? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Can we say amen? Come on, let's just agree together with our kids. I'm going to ask Pastor Danny to come tonight. Let's believe God, because this is, we die, and if they don't carry on, the legacy stops. The legacy stops. I don't want Torrance just for the Torrance name, because Torrance carries nothing. Come on, it's Torrance serving God. It's Torrance, the child of the Lord, the servant of God. Hallelujah. It's Torrance doing signs, wonders, and miracles. It's Torrance extending the kingdom of God on this earth. If my kids and their kids don't do that, there's no legacy. No, I don't want the legacy of alcoholism and drug and pornography. Yes. That's not the legacy that we want. Praise the Lord. Where's Danny? Come on, Danny. Let's agree together tonight. Come on, let's agree together. Pray as the Holy Ghost leads you.
Father, we bless you and we honor you tonight. And Lord, we want to say thank you for the opportunity given to us of where we can declare a thing and it shall be established.
Yes,
and even
Lord,
as your servant has been speaking, Lord, of a legacy of this house, we thank you tonight that there's a realignment of every member in this house, and therefore we commit every family to you. And Lord, we believe it. Lord, despite what has been the history and what has been, Lord, our past, we declare from this day going forward, even in this time, that there's a line that is drawn in the sand where when we look back, Lord, at our legacy of Pastor Fred and Sister Nell, Lord, of where there's been deliverance, there's been the call of God, there's the purpose of the Lord. So tonight, we resurrect purpose, Father, in the name of the Lord. We resurrect the call of God. We resurrect, O God, the desires and the plans of God. You said, O Lord, that you have plans for us, O God, plans that are good, plans, O God, of where you desire, that the unfolding of your word shall influence this world. You declared that as children, Lord, and families, O God, you have called us, that we are part, we are in this world, but Lord, we are not of that world. So we thank you, the legacy, Lord, upon our lives will be one, oh God, of where we say, oh God, we've been put in a circumstance, but Lord, we are able, Lord, to change the circumstance. Therefore, tonight, we declare in the name of the Lord that there's a rising up of the spirit of faith within every one of us, oh God, of where we will say that the old is the old, oh God, that there's new things in you, and you desire, Lord, to do a new thing. Therefore, tonight, we declare activated within and for every family, oh God, is a new thing. Your word is declared, behold, I will do a new thing. We release that word upon families and this house, oh God, of where we say, everyone that's connected to this house, oh God, there shall be breakthroughs, oh God. There shall be, Lord, a new alignment. Lord, for our children, we declare in the name of the Lord, they shall not go down a path, oh God, of where they are lost and there's darkness, there's addiction, and there's just, Lord, bondage, but we declare the liberty of the Lord God Almighty.
Right.
It is for liberty that Christ has died to set
children.
Us free. Therefore, we declare our sons and our daughters, they'll be sensitive to the voice of the Lord, that even they will hear the voice of the Lord, like a little Samuel, oh God, of where, Lord, going and resting and, Lord, being in position, they will hear the voice of the Lord, and even, Lord, there will be a sensitivity. We declare every word of the enemy assigned against them, every plot and every scheme, oh God, to, Lord, dull the voice of the Lord. We declare tonight that there shall be a breakthrough. Our children shall hear the voice of the Lord and build and go forward in Jesus' name.
Amen. Now let's do this confession, all right? Everybody lift your voice up right now. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. My children are a blessing. Say that one more time. My children are a blessing. My lineage will turn out good. My children will make me proud. My children will be powerful in this world. My descendants will be strong throughout this world. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. My lineage will be honored everywhere. My children will be successful wherever they may be, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Point number two. Here's point number two. We ask that a sincere and genuine faith in Jesus Christ will be our family treasure.
Yes,
I mean, if you believe that God is a God of families.
Amen.
God of families. And we know that the work of the enemy today is to dismantle and discredit families. We don't know who's male and female. No, we do know. Biologically, you're either male or female. Biologically.
Amen.
Biologically. Got nothing to do with what you're feeling. Right? Biologically. And I tell you what, I've heard highly educated people. They biologically, I don't know what's the... I have no words for them. But anyways, be that as it may, we are praying for our family units. We believe in families. In this house, we believe in families. We believe a man marries a woman and they become husband and wife. That's what the Bible says. I'm just saying what the Bible says. We're just in agreement with what the Bible declares. We ask that a sincere and genuine faith in Jesus Christ will be our family treasure. Give me those scriptures. All right, here's the scriptures. I'm calling up memories of your sincere and unqualified faith, the leaning of your entire personality on God in Christ, in absolute trust and confidence in His power, wisdom, and goodness, a faith that first lived permanently in the heart of our grandmother, Lois, and your mother, Eunice. And now I'm, so here we can see from grandmother to mother that now is in the heart of Timothy. Three generations right there. Three generations. Three generations. What's the next scripture? What's the next scripture? Each generation will announce to the next your wonderful and powerful deeds. Hallelujah. Come on. As parents, when you see the next generation, when you see your children and their children and their children's children, we are declaring that each and every generation that has come out of our loins will announce to the next generation the wonders of God, the splendors of God, the signs and wonders and miracles of God. That was our lineage, by the way. That was our legacy from Smith Wigglesworth all the way to William Seymour, all the way through Nicholas Bengu and Richard and Getty and all the other wonderful men and women of God that God has raised up in South Africa from different ethnicities and cultures and tribes. That's our legacy. Let's declare, let's get the declaration up right now. Okay, those of you watching at home, you lift your voice as well with us, all right? Here we go. Generation to generation will honor and worship Jesus. Faith in Jesus will be successfully passed from one generation to another. Each generation in my lineage. Stop. Let's go back. Each generation in my lineage. I don't know about your lineage and her lineage and his. I'm taking responsibility for my lineage. You are taking responsibility for your lineage in Jesus' name. Let's say that again. Each generation in my lineage will tell their children of the saving power of Jesus. Miracles, signs, and wonders are the DNA of my family tree. Say that again. Bring that back. Signs, wonders, and miracles are the DNA. One more time. Are the DNA of my family tree. Let's continue. Hallelujah. Success and prosperity are passed down from generation. Oh, come on. You can say that better than that. One more time. Success and prosperity are passed down from generation to generation. My children will surrender their entire self to God in Christ. Every generation in my lineage will encounter and keep fully kindled the genuine fire of the Holy Spirit power. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, if you believe that, shout hallelujah. If you believe that this morning, we are standing here for our generation. When we are dead and gone, the generations that have come out of our loins, our lineage, is still going to be praising God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, you better shout and believe it. Like, act like you believe it tonight. Act like you believe it tonight. Yeah. We're not letting the enemy run roughshod over us. No, sir. No way. No way, Jose. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Here's the third point with regards to legacy. We ask that our generation will pass salvation in Jesus down to the last generation. If there's something that we can say about the lineage that we carry, the DNA that we carry, is to win the lost at any cost. We are living in a day and age where we do not stop to preach the gospel. We're not here to dilute and fit the gospel into a woke society. No. I wanted to say something, but anyways. We're not trying to be woke here, all right? We're not trying to fit the gospel to fit into a woke whatever. It's time for woke to catch a wake up, man. Get it a slap on the side of the head. What? What? Hallelujah. Praise God. So we keep on preaching the gospel and we keep on winning the lost at any cost. Hallelujah. We keep discipling. Amen. Our job is to disciple. What's your job? To disciple. Hallelujah. People look at you. You're a walking, living, talking Bible. When they look at you, you are an epistle written by the Holy Ghost. And people look at you and they can see Jesus and feel Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. We ask that our generation will pass salvation in Jesus down to the last generation. Give me the scriptures quickly. Let's have a look at that. And we will not forget it. Our people will be telling the story to the last generation. We will all praise the Lord and tell about the amazing things He did. Amen. Place these words on your hearts. Get them deep inside you. Tie them on your hands and foreheads as a reminder. Teach them to your children. Talk about them wherever you are, sitting at home or walking in the street. Talk about them from the time you get up in the morning until you fall into your bed at night. That's Deuteronomy chapter 11 and verse 19 in the Message translation. And we've got to believe that. I mean, I wasn't born into a Pentecostal home. My parents were not born again. My grandparents were not born again. So I could have been anything, but I had a definite born again experience. And we've got to trust the Lord that now that we are born again and our children are born into a born again family, that doesn't mean that they're born again.
Yes, yes, yes.
They need to have a definite born again encounter.
Come on. Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah. Come on. We raise them up. We pray. We read the Bible. We do everything. But they have to have a certain born again encounter on their own. They need that.
Come on.
They can't imbibe you. Say, I'm born again because my father is born again. No, no, no. You. When was the day? What happened? Can you tell me the day? If you can't tell me the day, you're not born again, sweetheart. I love you, but actually you're not born again. I remember the one time I was counseling somebody. I said, well, when were you born again? And she said, well, I was actually born again in my mother's womb. While I was in my mother's womb. I thought, well, okay, is this like an Elizabeth Mary story? When Elizabeth came into contact with Mary, you know, the baby left in her womb and John received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. But actually, there needs to be a specific time. When did you encounter Christ? When was it made known to you that you were a sinner? You needed the forgiveness of God and the cleansing power of Jesus' blood in your life. Huh? It's very quiet in this. What church are we in tonight? Episcopalian? Engia Kerk. All right, praise the Lord. Come on, let's get this declaration going. Let's get this one, the last one, all right? The last one, and then we're going to pray. Homes, a place of instruction in the Word of God. The talk in our home is not filled with gossip, but the truth of the Word. The Word of God sinks deep into the hearts and souls of every family member. Our families do whatever it takes to remember what God says to us in His Word. The first thing we talk about in our family is the goodness of God. The last thing we talk about in our family, our family will not forget the Word of God. Hallelujah. Say that one more time. Our family will not forget the Word of God. One more time. Our family will not forget the Word of God. Hallelujah. Lift your hands right now. Father, we just declare tonight as we bring families and marriages and our children, that You are a generational God, from one generation to another. We want to thank You that You said in Genesis 3 and 15 that there is definitely, not if, there is definitely enmity between the seed of the serpent and the seed of the woman. And we know that hell is doing whatever it can to come against our seed. That we know that hell and every demon and every demonic force is doing whatever it can to abort our seed, to diminish our seed, to distract our seed, to get our seed into a woke mentality. But we come against that tonight in the name of Jesus. And we declare the Word shall prevail. We declare signs and wonders and miracles shall prevail. We declare that what we have imbibed through our lineage and our deeds DNA through Dr. Brett and Sister Nell, and then through John G. Lake, and then Smith Wigglesworth, and then Reverend Nicholas Bengu, and Reverend Richard Ngedi. My God, the Pentecostal move, the flow of the Holy Ghost that started in Azusa Street with Brother William Seymour. I declare over our children, I declare from one generation to another generation, however long it takes for you to come back for the church, but that we that are left behind and what has come out of our lineage shall declare the goodness of God. They shall be the ambassadors of Christ. They shall be on this earth declaring the wonderful works of our God, flowing in the supernatural, carrying the DNA of the Holy Ghost and the miraculous and the supernatural and the prophetic and everything that we have imbibed tonight, my God. We plead the blood over every family. We plead the blood over this generation and the one that is coming up right now, my God. Come on, let's pray for the up and coming generation. Let's pray for the up and coming generation. This country needs a fresh generation. It needs a fresh generation in every sphere of society. Come on, people. Come on. Hallelujah. Yes, God. We declare a righteous generation shall multiply in our city, Durban, in our country, South Africa. Men and women of God that know the Holy Ghost. Men and women of God that carry the righteousness, the purity, the integrity, the character of God. Men and women, young boys and girls that are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Who believe that with their God, all things, who believe, God, that you can still heal our land, who believe, God, that you can still do something wonderful, something amazing, something beautiful can emerge from our country, from our city, Durban, my God, in the name of Jesus, that you would place that burden, that cry on the inside, even as John Knox in Scotland prayed and said, give me Scotland or I die. I pray tonight, my God, that the fire of your spirit would come upon this generation and those that are watching online in the various cities and nations of this world. Let there be a generation, my God, that arises. A generation that says, I don't want what is fake. I don't want what is a pretense, but I want what is real. I want what is true. I want what is holy. I want what is right. I want what is peaceful. I want what is miraculous. I want what glorifies God. I want what will lift God up in the name of Jesus. I thank you for that generation. A generation. A generation, a generation that is not afraid to speak and to declare and prophesy. A generation, my God, that refuses to be silent, my God, in the name of Jesus. A bold generation, a young generation, a fresh generation, a generation that carries the fire of the Holy Ghost because of our forefathers, my God, because of what was deposited on the inside of us, on the inside of us. And we declare, let that generation rise. Let that generation rise. Let that generation rise in our city, Durban, in your city right now, wherever you are. Let that godly generation that carries the word of God, that carries the favor of God, that carries the scent of God, let that generation arise. 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 Let the seed of the woman, the lineage of Christ, the lineage of the kingdom, the lineage of righteousness, the lineage of signs, wonders, and miracles, the lineage of prosperity in the spirit, the anointing of God, a lineage of faith in God. Oh God, oh God, we beseech you tonight, let that generation arise, let that generation arise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, come on, lift your hands, shout.
declare the word of the Lord. Declare that generation with the eyes of our faith. We see that generation rising like a mighty man of war. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Let that generation rise. Let that generation rise.
Come on. Our country needs us tonight. Our city needs us. Your city, wherever you're watching from, needs you tonight. Needs that generation to step up to the mark. Hallelujah.
Let that generation rise.
Sing it.
Let that generation rise. Let that generation rise. Let that generation rise.
Let that generation rise. A godly generation. A God-fearing, God-honoring
generation.
Not ashamed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let that generation arise in every one of our cities here in South Africa, my God. It's time for that generation to arise in Africa, from the top of Africa to the bottom of Africa, from the west to the east of Africa. Let that generation arise. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let that generation arise. Come on, like a mighty man of war. Like a mighty man of war. Like a mighty man and woman of war. The church, the generation of the church of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. A generation that will execute the government of God on this earth. A generation that will execute the laws of God, the purity of God, the righteousness of God. A generation that every place where they set their feet, my God, will leave the print, the footprint of Jesus, the footprint of signs, wonders, and miracles. Hallelujah. Let that generation rise. Let that generation rise.
Let that generation rise.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
How many of you felt Hallelujah. Something happen tonight,
we believe it tonight
when it comes to legacy? Amen. And generation. Wow. Praise the Lord. Father, as we go our various ways tonight, we thank you for all of those that are watching online, Christian Center Church, wherever they may be watching tonight, God, we bring them to you. And what you have done and said and how you have moved here in this place, thank you that you're moving right where they are tonight. And Lord, as we go blessed, we go highly favored, we go anointed, we go with the boldness, the power of God, in Jesus' name. And everybody said, you are the blessed of God. You are the blessed of God. Pastor Ron, happy birthday to you today. It's Pastor Ron Foster's birthday. Can we sing happy birthday for him quickly?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Praise God. Amen. Father, we want to thank you for Pastor Ron and Judith tonight. Thank you for the blessing they are to us. For the many years that they've been so faithful to this ministry, to this house, associated with us. And today I pray, may it have been a special day for him, God. I want to thank you that every provision is taken care of, my God. Every provision, that there will be no lack. I declare this year, Pastor Ron, you will know no lack. You and your family will know no lack. I declare everything is paid for in full. I declare everything is owned by you. But in this year, you will know no lack because of your faithfulness and your commitment to me, says the Lord, and to my word, you will know no lack, and I will pour my blessing upon you in Jesus' name. Amen. Good night, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your evening.